actually do. I've been in the gym with him. I've seen him be in the ring with high-level performance fighters, and I know what he can actually do. So for that, the performance that you had today, I rated it like a 3 because it could have been better.
Your first 5 fights, you know, you finished the fight.
Were you surprised you went the distance with your opponent tonight?
No, I wasn't surprised. You know, that was the goal. The goal was they find an opponent, strong opponent that doesn't give up, a real strong Cuban. And I mean, I got the experience, and I did 6 rounds, and I did it when I wasn't feeling good, and that's definitely, you know, a lot of levels up after this. So yeah.
Did he hurt you at all in any of those first rounds? It looked like he caught you some clean shots.
No, he got me, but then like it was like, it's good that I know how it feels now to get hit with 10 ounce gloves. I didn't really feel it, but like, I didn't feel it at all, to be honest. But hope I don't, you know, in my future career.
After going, you know, the decision with you, respect your opponent a little bit more going to the decision with him?
What?
Going the whole 6 rounds, did you have a little more respect for your opponent at the end?
No, I always have respect for my opponent. I mean, it's boxing, you know. We are we're the modern day gladiators, you know. It's kill to be killed, you know. So at the end of the day, it's all respect for the fighter, you know.
Now that you had the fight, what do you feel like you need to work on going into your next fight and your next camp?
I mean, it's boxing, man. There's a lot. I mean, even Lomachenko got a lot to work on. I mean, I got a lot to work on. You know, I gotta tighten up. I gotta learn how to pick my shots. You know, there's a lot I gotta work on.
You were loading up with the right hand quite a bit, especially the last 2 rounds.
Yeah.
Are you looking to finish it?
My corner was telling me, you know, I'm throwing the same punch over and over again. But it's because I every time I threw it, he kept missing it. Like, he kept getting hit with it. And I wanted to, like, you know, like a one-punch quitter type of thing.
Yeah.
But I guess it didn't work out, so
yeah. Next
time.
Were you frustrated at all that he wouldn't come out of his shell, that he stayed guarded up, and you know, were you frustrated that he wouldn't engage with you at all?
Yeah. No, I mean, listen, he's a good opponent. I got much respect for him, and we're gonna definitely step it up a lot, you know, my next fight. So yeah.
Last question for me. What are your thoughts on the passing of two fighters, you know, within the past few weeks? You know, what do you think about that? As you know, you put your life on the line in there.
I mean, boxing is not a game. You know, people be like, oh, basketball, let's play basketball. We can't play boxing. You know, we do this for people's entertainment. But, you know, people don't understand that getting hit with 10-ounce gloves is a big thing, you know what I mean? So, like, but then, like, it's, you know, they're in a better place now. That's all I got to say. All right, like, you know, Maxim, another guy, you know, passed away. But they're all in a better place right now, so.
Any message for your fans and the people around the world, especially your hometown of New York?
I mean, I love everybody, you know. I love everybody. And, you know, too much are going to come back stronger.
Is it going to be 160 or 154? Eddie said you can make 154. Is that?
No. Yeah. So my goal was, like, you know, to do a couple fights 160, but once the fights start getting more serious, then go down to 154 because I want to take over 154. So yeah, no, definitely, no. I could make. Yo, I'm thinking about what's below 154.
47.
I was thinking about making 47. Like, to be honest. You know, because my whole amateur career, you know, I always fought. Like, I remember when I won the Team USA, I won for 165, but the weight below was 152, and I weighed 153. The date of the weigh-in, you know what I mean?
So and they were like, bigger guys.
Yeah, and they were like, yo, just you gotta lose 1 pound, you go to 152. I'm like, nah, let me go to 165. And I fought everybody that's, you know, like walking around 180, and I stepped on the scale of 153, and I didn't even lose weight.
You certainly carry the power, bringing the power down to 54. Do you think it's necessary to bring it down to 47? I mean, you don't want to drain yourself and risk losing that ham.
47.
I'm telling you, like, my body, the way, like, if I get rid of everything, just like train muscle, I could do 147. But then again, like, I'm just 54 is like, that's the weight. But I'm saying, like, I won't be surprised if I make 147. Like, I won't be surprised.
Can you briefly explain the Zulu on your shirt and what it means to you?
Oh no, this is Supreme. This is Supreme shirt.
Okay, just Supreme. Supreme shirt.